I'm very honored today to be chatting to the brilliant Denny. Thank you for joining us.
Thanks, Camilla.
Now, you're a bit of a Renaissance man. Uh-huh. Well, because you're the director of the West Asfields Leagues.
Yeah.
And you also have your own event company.
That's right, yes.
And you're also the manager of talent. You have the Dead Singers Band, which is just a phenomenal achievement. How do you find the time?
With great difficulty. Look, it means a lot of being organised.
So your event management company is the Red Letter.
A Red Letter Day.
Fantastic.
Make every day a Red Letter Day.
Brilliant, that, isn't it? And you do big festivals as well.
We do a festival called Uberfest, yes. which is, we have about 40 bands, and now we do it all over Australia.
And well, you're always really good at spotting young talent, aren't you?
Well, I been at it for a while, you know.
Well, you started with Throb when you were really young.
I did, yes. Yeah, so just out of school, first band, Throb, and had. Fortunately for us, we had a big hit. It just went from there, I guess, you know. And so
that was Fortune Teller.
The Fortune Teller.
That was great. Those songs are just fantastic. The Masters Apprentices.
The Masters was a great time. We had a fantastic time over in England.
And didn't you also run a band with your brother as well?
Yeah, Colin and I ran a band called Good Time Charlie.
That used to be His Majesty.
His Majesty morphed into Good Time Charlie.
Yes. You just have band after band and band and success after success. What's your secret?
There's no explanation for
it's
it,
just
really.
Got the golden touch.
Well, it just seems that we've been really fortunate. You know, we always say you're right place at the right time.
Yes.
You know, but I remember when I was young, I used to rehearse for 8 hours when I get a chance at something, I want to be good enough to take it, you know.
Just practice.
That's
practice.
Right, and actually worked.
So how did you handle such success at such a young age?
that's a good point, because when the Throb took off, it really did take off all over Australia, and all of a sudden you're elevated to this sort of...
godlike status.
I remember in Adelaide once, came around the corner and there was a cardboard cutout, life-size, picture of me and the other guys, you know, and that did freaks you out, because you're very young and you go, wow, isn't it? Wow, I must be a star or something, you know. But you soon brought it back down to earth when the band finishes and stuff like that. Thankfully, we just went from band to band, and everything's worked for us, so it's good.
It's fantastic. And the Dead Singer Band at the moment is your passion.
Absolutely.
It's
fantastic. It is a band that we all get along with. It's like a family. Always a joy to play. And we're playing the stuff of people that we personally knew, that we were friends of, lots of absolutely legends, you know. Mm. And sadly, they've passed on. But we can... help to keep keep it alive for people, and I love it when we finish a show or something. Somebody comes up to me and says, "Gee, I didn't know that about Billy Throb. Thanks for letting me know that." You know.
And tell us a bit about your work at the Leagues Club.
The Leagues Club, look, it is a fantastic place. I'm
obviously a West Tigers fan.
I grew up loving West Magpies. When I came back here, somebody said, "You've got to come out and see West play." So I did, and then went every week to see the day. So I got to know all the people, the footballers really well. I got to know the administration and all that. And so then I became a debenture holder of this club here at West at Ashfield, and then I became a director. I've been a director for quite a while now.
It's a great club, isn't it?
Yeah, it is a very, very good club. You know?
Very well presented.
What I really love about the club is the fact that we give a lot away to communities and charities.
Yes,
and
I saw
all
your charity work, really. You've done everything. So, Cancer Council.
Yeah, it's very pleasing to be able to be in a club that's really helping the community. Yeah, I love that.
That's very important as well. And the West Magpies also builds rugby talent as well, doesn't it?
Yes, yeah. They're the sort of feeder club to West Tigers these days. And,
what advice would you give anyone who wants to go into this industry?
Art industry is definitely a hard industry, always has been, but this day and age, it is really difficult. The only thing that I can keep saying to young bands is to stick together.
So for the Songwriters Association, what does that entail?
It's the biggest grassroots songwriting organisation in Australia.
Wow.
And every year we have the biggest songwriting competition in Australia, and all the winners from that It's all over Australia, and all the winners of all the genres, there's 13 genres a year. We get to a top 10 every year. We have a awards night, and we get all the winners, even if they're from Darwin or something, they get flown to Sydney, and they get to play their song. All the music heavyweights, they all arrive and give out the awards.
Talent Scott.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for talking
to us. No, thank you, Camilla.
Really,
it's been
really
fantastic.
Good to see you. I'm going to go. I'm definitely going to see the Dead Singer Band. Okay. Check them out on Facebook, guys, and we'll see you again next time. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.